Now, there are going to be situations where you have a visual that you want to allow your users to drill into and get a little bit further insights based on what they're selecting. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to use this drill through feature to get that done. Let's say our goal here is we want to allow the user to drill in from this customer and go to another page where there's more details and have it just for that customer. We would go from Aaron Campbell, and if we selected that person, well, let's say it took us to this page, sales by year, and we would want this to be just for that individual selected. In our case, again, in our case, it's an individual, but it could be for anything. My first thought is to do something here on this page, but it's actually not. Where you make this change is on the visual where you want them to drill into. So in this case, we're looking to go into here, and this is where we'll actually set that attribute. We'll select this component here. Now this drill through area here is how we'll get this done. We said we want to be able to select a customer name to drill in. So what we do is go to customer name, drag it onto this filter. Now what will happen is any other component that has a customer name can drill into this page here. We're allowing it to happen. If we go back to this other visual, right click, now we see this option for drill through, and it's giving us the name of that page where that visual has it. We said, you know what, if you have this customer name field, you're allowed to drill through into here, and we'll filter it based on that field. So let's select this. Now it's taken us here and filtered this for us because we set that filter. I'll also point out that because we're saying keep all filters, it's keeping everything as it is. So we have category name here, and it's keeping those the same here. You'll see that down here. So now that worked. And if we were to go back and if we select this one, drill through, now we have this filtered by that person. And what you'll notice here is this little guy up here. Whenever you add something to this drill through, it's automatically going to add this button here. And all this is a back button. It's going to allow you to go back to the page where you came from. Because we're in editing mode here, I'll control click, and it'll send me back here. And that's the workflow they're trying to set up. So drill through, see it, go back. Drill through, control click, go back. If we look at this visual here, there is no customer name. So when we right click, we don't see that drill through option. It's not allowing us. But let's say we want that as well. We'll come back into this guy again. And it's this time we'll add color to one of the available drill through fields. Now, if we go back here, right click, drill through, sales by year is now an option. Select this, and all of this is going to be filtered by that color. So as I mentioned initially, all this is right here is a back button. So let's say you wanted to customize this and use a custom image. What you can do is insert an image. I have a custom button here that I found, and in the format, we can set the action to back, and it'll function the same way. So now if we were to control click here, start doing some of these same motions, it'll work the same way. And we can get rid of this guy. Let's say this is what we wanted, and there we go. So that'll do it for this video. Pretty straightforward on how you can use drill throughs in Power BI to enhance the way your users can interact with your dashboard and add some more advanced functionality to your reports. If you found this helpful, please feel free to like the video or leave a comment, and I'll do my best to answer your questions. If you want to see more content like this, if this is interesting to you, feel free to subscribe. But as always, thanks again for watching, and I will see you at the next video.